Hello, explorers, and welcome to another video. So, today I'm going to talk about release handling in Maven. And I built this very advanced program here that types Hello World! And this program is running version, and then I use the version demo to get the class. And I get the package of that class, and then I get the implementation version of this package. So that's the thing I wanted to show here. So this will actually give me the Maven implementation version. So I can show in my program which version have I built. So let's change this from Hello World to Hello Explorers. And let's go into the Maven configuration file here. First off, I have some properties that I think is quite nice to have in your Maven setup. That I say that this targets 1.8, and I also have a source version of 1.8. This makes things very much easier when you're compiling and testing things that you're actually building to the correct version and testing against the correct version, and the tooling will actually help you more to stay within the boundaries that you have for your project. And another thing is to set the encoding to UTF-8. Which also could help you in your source files, your resource files and everything, so you don't get a mixed encoding between your different files that could lead to a lot of errors. And the places you need to set encoding is in the build source encoding, so that's your source files, reporting output, that's test reporting and so on. Maybe not important, but could be nice to have those in UTF-8 as well. And then you have your source encoding, a typo here. And so resources source encoding. So that's all your resources. They should be in UTF-8 as well. And then archetype encoding, also UTF-8. So if you have all these properties in your file, then you will remove a lot of the headaches, I guess. And then here we have our little setup for this project. This should actually be @ project version. I think one of my rollbacks didn't handle that correctly, so this will take the version of this project and put it here for my tagging. So that's the way I want my things to be tagged. So you have an @ symbol and then project version. So you could actually have, let's say, a V before that, so you get version, if you like that, in your tags. And these are the tags on GitHub or on GitLab or whatever you have your Git install. And then you get the connection information from Git. So in my case, it's SEM, and then I tell it to use the Git command, and then the URL to your Git repository, and you need to set the connection for all the base, then normal connections, and then the developer connection is actually when you're pushing a new release and so on, it will use that. And then this information is more where can I find your repositories, that's more of a documentation thing. And in order to get this to work in Windows, you need to open your Git bash and run a few commands. So let's go in here, and then you need to run these SSH key gen with the -t RSA. So you create an RSA key with the 4096 bits. You could choose something else if you like that, and then you will comment it with your email address, and it will generate some keys for you, and you will give it a passphrase so you can use it. And then you follow this guide. You will actually add that to your GitHub page. In my case, I went to the repository under deployment keys and added my key here and said that this should be a read-write key, so I can actually push directly to this repository. You could do it for your whole account depending on your setup, but this is important to get the Maven versioning correct. And if everything is correct, you should be able to make releases. So that's where we want to come to. So we make releases with different tags here. So every separate build that you make, you will create a new tagged release in GitHub. So you can actually get that version and run that version again, or make a new release of that version. So that's where we want to end up. And in order to do this, we need a few things. First off, I think it's very good to put in a Maven assembly plugin. And this plugin is just to build your builder, so you build a packaging. And if you configure this and set a few things to this, it will actually create a package with all your dependencies and everything that you have added to your Maven configuration, so you can actually get a runnable jar after this. And two fields that I think is important to put in is this default implementation entries. This will give you the version information in your manifest, so that's important to put in, so you will get the version information later in your program. And I don't know if you need the default specification entries. It was mentioned on the same page, and it will give you some more entries in your Maven configuration file. I'm not sure that that's important to get the versioning in your project. And then you, of course, you need the main clause, so you say what clause will be run when I run this jar file. Then I can put on a descriptor to tell the build process what suffix to put on all the jar files built with dependencies, so I can see the difference between the original jar file with just the build classes, and then I have one with dependencies. It will build one with sources, and it will also build one with documentation. So we'll have a few different jar files. And then I need to push this into the build process. So I will say that this plugin should be run in the package phase, and it should be run on the single package goal. So it is actually run when I run my Maven commands. And if we go here and I run Maven package, it will go through and build a package. So if I look in the target directory here, I will actually have a 0.4 snapshot that I built this time. And if I run version demo 0.4 snapshot, it doesn't have a manifest file. Okay, so I need to run the actual jar with dependencies. And then it will say, hello explorers, this program is running 0.4-snapshot. So now I have built a package, but this is not a release. This is just something that I built to test the program out or run it in a non-tested and ready deployed version. Because when you're running the release process, it will run all your unit tests and everything before it actually will create a full release for you. So if we go back here, we need also to specify the release plugin. And it's just this group ID and artifact ID for the release plugin with the version. And the configuration I need to do is say that this should be run on the pre-integration test goal. So that's where in the actual running it should go. So this should be before the integration test, but after the unit test. So that's where I want this build to actually happen. And my preparation goal is package, so it need to be packaged before I can actually create a release. And that's of course very important. And then I will allow timestamped snapshots, so I could get some timestamp information on when this snapshot was made. So that is something else that you can display in your program if you like. And then I have my tag name format. So this is the format how I should create my tags. And then I have remote tagging set to false. And this is a new flag for me. And this is actually if you want your Maven to go out to your remote channel and create a remote tag before building and pushing. And usually I run with this true on, but on GitHub I actually got some permission denied errors because I can't create remote tags. I need to push them after the build process. And Maven will do that for you, so you don't need to do that. But it will not create the tag before it builds. It will push it after the build. So that's an important flag to put there. If you're not allowed to actually create remote tags, you're not just allowed to push them, then you need to set this flag to false. There is also a flag that actually tells the build process that you're not allowed to push at all, and that should be done later. So you do that in a manual step if you like that. So there's a lot of different flags that you can set here, but this is what I needed to get it to work with GitHub. So when this is done, I can go back to my console here, and I can actually run Maven release prepare. And when I run prepare, it will fail because it actually noticed that I have two modified files here. And that's a really good thing for us, that it tells us that you're not done with your release. You haven't thought this through. Here are some modified files that you haven't pushed into your or committed to your Git repository. So we need to fix this problem, of course. So we'll do git status, and we see here that the POM file have changes. We made some changes in the POM file. We also made some changes in our program. And we have also created the release properties, and that's because I started the release process, and that we can fix with either release rollback, and rollback is used if you are further down in the release process, you have actually changed version and so on, then you need to do a release rollback to remove that work and get a clean build after that. But in my case, I only have the release properties, so if I just started the process, I can clean it out, so I don't have that file. So that will clean out that release properties. And then I just have these files changed, so I will stage my POM file, I will stage my source file, and I will commit this with the message commit during recording. Not a very good message, but good enough for this purpose. So I will push my changes to GitHub, and now I can start my release again. Release prepare. So here I start a prepare process. It asks me, okay, what do you want this version to be called? You are creating a new version of this program. What version should it be? It suggests that 0.4, which was my snapshot version, might be the version that I want to build now. So I say, okay, just press enter there. It will create 0.4. What do you want the label on your SEM to be? And that's probably good that those match, so I say that it's 0.4 there as well, so just enter. And then it will ask, okay, you will start a new development now, so maybe you should have a new snapshot. So 0.5, is that good for you? Yeah, 0.5 snapshot sounds fine, so I press enter. And now it will prepare my build, and actually, when it have built everything, it will have created a tag and a release on GitHub. So if we go back to GitHub, we do a refresh here. I have a build target of 0.4. It has already created my release. It's built, but I don't have the actual build done on my system. In order to actually build the version locally, I do a perform. And this will actually go to GitHub, take this branch, the new branch of 0.4, check that out to a local directory, and build that release for me. And when that's done, I will actually have a file in target, check out, so it has checked out the files, and then target again, so that's the target folder of the checkout. And here I will have this version demo, jar with dependency 0.4, and if I run that, it says, hello explorers, this program is running the version 0.4. And this doesn't say snapshot anywhere. So this is a pure version, it has run all your different tests, your unit tests, it has created documentation and other things. So we can go into this here. We actually have Java doc, we have sources, and we have this jar with dependencies. So that was what I wanted to talk about today, how to manage your build process within Maven. And I really hope that you learned something today. If you have any questions about Maven release management, then please leave me a comment down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And I really hope to see you in the next one.